Hello, it's me, Isabel Gowdy. So I was just stopping by because I've been doing some things that I figured would be concerning to some people, but yet nobody has said anything to me about none of it. So, you being a man of the church, I thought that you might have a better idea and could, tell me if I need to be worried or not. Great. I'm just gonna start at the beginning then, if that's all right with you. Okay. So, this is back in what was the year? 1647, I think. So, I'm just going along, minding my own business, and next thing I know, there's this fella in a grey suit, and he comes up to me, and he's like, "Oh, Isabel, you know what would be real cool?" And I was like, "I don't, mysterious man." He was like, "Listen, I'm not a stranger." And I was like, "You look like a stranger. I'm pretty sure I know everybody in this town." And he was like, "No, I'm not. Actually, listen, I'm the devil." And I was like, "No way. That's totally cool." And then he was like, "Yeah, it is." So he asked me then if I wanted to go to the church and get a baptism. So I was like, "Well, I know looking back, I probably should have said no, but once in a lifetime opportunity." So I was like, "Absolutely." So me and the devil go to the local church, the one, and we get inside and he drains all of my blood into a pool. And then I get in the pool. I don't know how I'm still living at this point. So I get in the pool and then, does a regular dunking and whatnot. And then I come out and guess what? All the blood goes back into my body. So it's like, wow, that's really cool. And then I was like, I know. So anyway, now that we've got you baptized, we need to give you a new name. And I was like, nice. Not that Isabel isn't a nice name, because it's got a good ring to it. But I'm thinking, this is a devil. He's gonna have something cool and exotic and, something kind of sexy. But instead, he's like, "All right, Isabel, from this day on, I'm gonna be calling you Janet." And I'm just thinking to myself, Janet? No way. If I knew that Janet, no offense to Janet, but if I knew that was the other choice, I would not have chosen it. I would not have gone along with it. But now here we are and I can't change that. What am I gonna do? Tell Satan, no, thank you. That's not for me. So anyway, we've been dating casually since then. Well, mostly. I mean, here's the thing. There's 13 other girls. That's right. They're all from here though. Of course. 'Cause they're my friends and such, but we can get into that later. But anytime me and the girls feel going out and having a nice time, or hexing somebody, we'll just, pop a broom in the bed with our husbands. That's right. And I don't even notice. I don't know how. It's honestly quite shocking. And there's been times that I've even come home and, I've gotten in late and me husband's up and the broom's still on the bed and I'm just looking at him, looking at the broom and being like, "How did you not notice?" Also, I'm here now, so it's just odd. Anyway, I don't know if they even really care. So, me and the girls, pop the broom in the bed, and then no clothes, nothing like that. You know, that's just silly at that point because I don't even care. And then we, you know, just take some reeds or something like that and then fly off into the woods. If you want to get real crazy, if you're like bored or something, then a lot of times we'll, you know, turn into a cat or a dog, a toad, you know, a rabbit, something like that. It doesn't really matter. But the thing is, you know, you can do that if you like. I don't always like it. It's typically just when I'm like, you know, don't have anything better to do. So we go off into the woods and of course it is a party. Like once you get there, fire's going and you know, everybody's naked and they're dancing. And like, I've never seen people dance like this before, I can tell you. So like all these cool new moves, and then like Satan is there, and you know, he's always looking good, which is kind of weird because he's also very scary. And you know, with all the like touching and cuddling and you know, clutching that we do, it's like not necessarily biblical. So what I mean is, like, you know what I'm saying? Well, okay, here's the thing. If, in a biblical sense, I know all those women, and I also know the devil consorting. That's right. So anyway, also, one thing that is shocking every time is Satan's, you know what I'm gonna say. So like every time, it's just huge. I mean, I don't even know how to describe it, it's so scary, like massive. And not only that, but then there's like, you know, like all these scales and prongs and such coming off it. And every time I'm thinking like, no way is that coming near me, no way at all. So, you know, but then next thing you know, you're naked, they're naked, and, you know, everybody's touching, and then all of a sudden you're having a great time, and you don't even know why you said no in the first place. Because then eventually, you know, you, like, change your mind, because he's a very persuasive guy, I got to say. But no matter. So, after that's all done, then, you know, like, if you don't do it right, though, he'll, like, hate you and stuff. It's not very nice, I got to say. It's one thing I don't like. But at that point, again, you don't even care because I've had my fun. So, listen, then he's just like, hey, I need you to go and, you know, do these things for me. And I'm like, what? And he's like, well, you know, the crops this year? And I'm like, yes, of course I do. And he's like, I need you to go plow them with like little tiny toads and little tiny plows. And you're thinking, wow, that sounds really cute. And it's not, I can tell you that right now. Having to do that, like, think about that. Farming all those fields with little tiny toads and little tiny plows. It's no fun. It's all, I can say. So anyway, after that, it makes like the crops go bad, which I'm sure you've noticed. And then like, you know, he'll say other things that's like, oh, I don't like that lady. So can you like go make her kid sick or her, you know, husband die? And I'm like, of course, obviously. And then like, well, for that, there's different things for like kids. You can, you know, get a doll. And sometimes you put like little needles in it and it doesn't kill him or nothing, but it does make him real sick sometimes, and you know, get like bumps and scrapes and such. And then for the adults, you use like fairy arrows. Oh, they're real, I can tell you that. And then, but they live underground and it's cold. You know, that's where you get your arrows, so you know, you got to do the tail ends. So anyway, you get those and then you like shoot them at people, and then they get sick or they die, or you know, more often, which is so not fun, is that you got to get like, you know, one of their dead relatives, which is hard enough. You have to wait for them to die, and then you got to go dig it up again by yourself. Have you ever tried it? It's not cool. And then, you know, you find, so you get your body, and then you dig them up, and then you rebury them and poo. That's right, poo. I mean, you could get that from anywhere though. So, you know, a lot of times I'll just wait for people to throw out buckets or, you know, dig a cat hole, and then I'll just go back to the cat hole and just take their poo. But I don't like doing that because then I end up going home and smelling like a dog's bollocks a lot of times. So, you know, that's not my favourite. And he keeps asking me to do it. And I'm like, wait, only this? Is this a punishment? And he's like, no, of course not, Isabel. Actually, he doesn't even call me Isabel. He's like, of course not, Janet. You know, you're my favourite. And I'm like, you've literally said that to all the girls that have been there when you've said it. But you know, by that time we're all naked again and doing things, so it's totally cool. And but here's the thing. Anyway, nobody has even pointed a finger at me, and I'm just growing suspicious that nobody's, you know, taking my work seriously. And I just want to know that somebody out there is appreciating the things I'm doing. Well, of course. You know, the fact that I can leave a broom in the bed and my husband doesn't even notice is crazy to me. Or all these other women, nobody says a thing. Or you want to hear the rest of it? Okay, well, you know, there is a lot more, and I love talking about this. I know, here's the thing, I need to be punished. I do, and I've been bad, you know, as I say. But like, I've enjoyed a lot of it, so I don't know how much of that I can take back. But, you know, that's not for me to decide at this point. I've already, like, made myself a boyfriend. You know, obviously with Satan. So, it's a whole mess and such. But anyway, I can just go pop that, you know, broom in the bed with my husband after I put him down, and I'll be back and we can talk about this all night if you like. Great, cool. I'm gonna go then, and I will see you back here in a few. Talk to you later.